Fort Matanzas National Monument is at the southern end of Anastasia Island and covers about 300 acres. Within those 300 acres, there are a series of remarkable, unique, and beautiful ecosystems. To the east is the Atlantic Ocean, a beautiful Atlantic beach, extensive sand dunes, and what is called a dune meadow. In addition, there is a coastal scrub environment, a maritime forest, and an estuary, which is the Matanzas River. Each of these environments is absolutely unique, and only certain kinds of plants and animals can live in each of them, principally because of the effect of just a few things: water, wind, waves, and salt. And those things in combination will define what plants can possibly survive. For example, on the front of the dune facing the ocean, very few plants can survive because of the high heat in the summer, the lack of nutrition in the soil, the high winds, and the salt that is carried by those winds. And as you move further away from the ocean, the plants begin to become more diverse and larger, again because of avoiding the effects of salt. Once you get to the maritime hammock, which is a coastal canopied forest, you find a completely different set of plants because, again, it is further away from the ocean. And here you begin to find large live oaks, eastern red cedars, and many other types of plants. And then we have an estuary, which is basically a semi-enclosed body of water that has both fresh water and access to the sea. In the case of the estuary that is adjacent to the National Monument, the route to the sea is through Matanzas Inlet. The estuary is extraordinarily important, extremely rich in life forms, tremendous biodiversity, ranging from the microscopic all the way up to bottlenose dolphin, and in warmer weather, even manatees. The estuary is a source of about 80% of all of the food that we consume from the ocean. The food that we consume from the ocean spent some time in the estuary, either breeding, laying eggs, being young fish or shrimp, or crabs, or whatever the case may be. So the health of the estuary is extremely important to all of us. One of the important things, I think, to remember as you walk on the inlet is that you never walk on the same beach twice. Every tide changes the beach, every week the beach changes, every month and every year. And when you see the inlet, you will have an opportunity to explore some of the powerful forces that are at work on the inlet that shape it and make it the beautiful place that it is. We hope that you will take advantage of the beautiful nature trails and paths and walkways that lead to and along the beach at Matanzas Inlet. It is an absolutely remarkable environment and well worth your time to visit and explore.